Welcome back to Alliances Heroes, where heroes in business align. To be part of our super community and find out more about Alliances, visit www.alliances.com. Now, back to our super host, David Cogan, founder of Alliances.
I'm a loving life. Oh my, this morning we had the lawyer specializing in the why factor. Why factor, knowing your why, McMurdyLaw.com. Now we all know our why. We just had the original shark from Shark Tank and creator of As Seen on TV, Kevin Harrington, who could be reached at KevinHarrington.tv. And later on in the show, we're going to have the CEO of Shark Reach Ventures, Scott Smith, a millennial media company, public company. Public symbol is SHRK. But let's go ahead and let's get started with the creator. Oh my, imagine having the opportunity to go to camp, not the type of camp you went to as a child, but one that can improve your life. Our next hero is one who says, quote, live your life in the making, not just making a living. He's Scott McLaine, founder of MoneyCampRocks.com. Scott, explain what MoneyCamp is and how it will benefit our listeners.
MoneyCamp is a program, David, that will completely transform your life. You show up on a Saturday morning or you take the program and you use it at home, and it literally helps you get out of debt, boost up your credit, set up a home accounting system, get on a spending plan, get on the same page with your spouse, and ultimately make life easier because you're mastering how you handle your money.
Now, I like what one of the titles is that you have. This is great. You're a money, health, fitness coach.
Exactly right.
So how does that work? How does that all incorporate?
Well, just imagine like normal fitness. It has to do with forming the habits, the discipline, the regular day-to-day activities. You can't go to the gym once in January, work out really hard, and hope that works for the whole year. It takes habits. So we teach people not only what they need to know, but we give them the habits to make a transformational experience and to help them transform their relationship with money going forward.
How long does it take for someone to form that type of habit?
It takes about 2 months, but we do it in a 30-day financial fitness challenge where we get enough of the forward momentum going that they can carry it on their own. And in reality, David, it never stops. Once you start with good habits, you've got to keep it going. It takes only 3 days to fall back on a bad habit. It takes 42, 43, 44 days to develop new ones in our experience. I know everyone thinks it's 21 days, but it's closer to 45 days to develop a habit.
I love it. And again, you can learn more by going to MoneyCampRocks.com. Scott,
oh, yeah.
You've helped many companies and their employees. ADT Security Systems, AT&T, Aflac, Bank of America, Farmers Insurance, the list goes on. Your business philosophy is, quote, business gets better when the people in the business gets better.
Absolutely.
But I don't understand that because a lot of companies, it just doesn't explain how that all works.
Okay, so throwing more dollars at your marketing isn't the way to grow your business. You want to invest in your employees. When your employees are empowered with the skill sets and the mindset and the philosophy and a culture of your company that's driven by success, that's driven on personal growth, when your employees are jazzed, your performance of the company, it gets jazzed. The customers feel it. The employees around the workplace like it. Turnover reduces. Employees feel empowered by the employer. They love where they're at. They want to go to work. They want to be there. So I'm telling you, you want to grow your business, invest in the employees in your business. And there's no better way than to invest in the financial skill sets and the financial well-being of your employees. Half of Arizona residents, half of American citizens are struggling financially. And so we offer a boot camp where we go into the company and actually work with the teams of the employers and work with their employees to boost their financial well-being.
Scott, what's a couple secrets to acquiring wealth?
Very simple. Spend less than you make and save. Save your money. Live off of, if you don't have a financial advisor working with you, somewhere between 12 and 30% of the money you make after you've paid your, if you're on a payroll and you get your money, 12 to 30% should go away towards some sort of a long-term investment.
I love it. Again, and we're talking to the creator of the top financial money camp, Scott McLaine, who could be reached at MoneyCampRocks.com, and you're listening to Alliances Heroes, Be a hero. Go to where entrepreneurs align. Be part of the community like Scott is at Eliances.com. That's Eliances.com. In fact, Scott, you're a member of Eliances. What's it like to be surrounded and be part of Eliances?
I was just about to talk about Eliances on my next segment, so thank you so much for asking. I have an old quote that says, and I didn't make it up, but if you are the smartest person in your group, you need a new group. Eliances is my new group. I have never walked into an environment where there is so many qualified, skilled, oriented, business-minded, entrepreneurial individuals doing business together in a community, and they're so open and receptive and work with you and are caring and giving. Eliances is the place to be. If you're in Arizona, you got to make sure you look it up at Eliances.com, without a doubt.
Fantastic. Now, many couples fight about money. Yet you can help restore financial confidence. Well, it's almost like you're a marriage counselor then too, is that right?
You know, my business partner, Matt Betts, who works with us on this, has a famous quote that he tells everybody. He says, you know what? The marriage divorce rate in America is about 50%, and about 50% of the people are struggling financially. Do you think there's a correlation?
Oh, that's scary. That's some scary stuff. Now, what inspired you to take on this task of educating the masses about their finances? Because you know what? A lot of people really don't like to talk about money.
That's exactly right. You know, David, I woke up at 3 in the morning one time financially hyperventilating and realizing that I was having a near-debt experience. And I transformed my life. I literally got myself into trouble financially, and living in Paradise Valley, training success around the country. Some of the companies that you named earlier, I was working and promoting Tom Hopkins seminars, doing sales workshops around the country. And here I am training success, but I find myself struggling financially because I was living on my income statement mindset. I'm making $7,000-$10,000 a month, and guess what I'm spending? $7,000-$15,000 a month. And when you're spending what you're making and your income stops and your bills don't, you get yourself in trouble, and that's what happened to me.
Tell me a couple of the, maybe just top 2 to 3 takeaways when I go to moneycamprocks.com. And again, I go through the camp. How long is the camp again?
It's a weekend program, or you do it at home in your own time over a weekend on a video-driven program, and then you engage new habits for a 30-day challenge.
Now, what's maybe 2 to 3 of the top things? I know that I'm going to learn a ton, but maybe 2 to 3 top things that you feel people take away.
One of the major takeaways is how you set up your home filing system. How do you organize those files in your house? Most people have online bills that they pay. They've got kind of a messed financial junk drawer of where they put stuff. Everything's alphabetized, or it's just a bunch of junk in a drawer. We organize that and dial it in, and it gives you a sense of mental clarity. You understand that every time you touch a file, is this benefiting my financial situation, or is this hurting my financial situation? Is this an asset, or is this a liability? Is this a bill, or is this, you know, income? And it all gets organized by itself. So that's one. Another one is really, what do you do with the money that you're making? And that's the tag phrase at the whole money camp. It's not what you're making, it's what you're doing with what you're making. And I'll say that one more time. It's not what you make, it's what you do with what you make. And I'll leave it at that so it sets in. That's the major point. We're all making enough money. It's the habits and what we're doing with that money once we make it that makes a major difference in our life.
Now, let me ask you one of the last questions, because I'm just dying to know. What can parents do now to help instill that in their children or teenagers in a relation to how they handle their money? Because I got to tell you, with my son, I give him $5. He's already spent $6, $7, or $8.
Yep. So first off, there's a couple things. First off, you can get them on the mindset that they don't just get money. There's no allowance. They have to trade value to the household in order to receive compensation for that value. And you get them learning right on that value into the marketplace drives the income. It's not an expectation. There's no entitlement to money. You got to go out and earn it. And if they're going to work around the house and earn the money, then they get it. Then once they get it, what you do with it, again, they've earned it. It's not what they make. It's what they do with what they make. 30 cents out of every dollar that they earn goes somewhere. 10% goes to charity, 10% goes into their long-term savings, and 10% they invest into some sort of equity, some sort of business. You go buy a wagon, and they mend the wagon and sell it back in the marketplace and make 10 bucks off it, like Jim Rohn says, one of my mentors. Teach them to save 10% and reinvest it into the community and to become little mini entrepreneurs.
Scott, I'm having you come over to my house after this, and we're going to talk to my son. You help so many people overcome their money issues and take healthy control of their finances. You're a hero. Go to moneycamprocks.com. We'll also have his contact information at eliances.com, where entrepreneurs align. And when we return, we're going to have the CEO of Shark Reach Ventures, a millennial media company, and it's a publicly held company, SHRK. Thank you so much, David Cogan with Eliances.